Hi, I'm Eric with My Boring Channel. I help people make websites. Now, in today's video, I'm going to talk about free SSL with WordPress. That's right, free SSL for your WordPress website. What do I mean? What I mean is, when people go visit your website, you want there to be a nice little padlock next to your URL that says secure. You don't want there to be an icon that says this website is not secure. Now, Google has made it clear to everybody that in the near future, there's going to be a much more prominent warning that says this website is not secure. So when people go visit your website and it's not secure, they're going to go, ah, this website isn't secure. Google is telling me so. And they're not going to trust your website. Also, there could be a slight increase in search engine rankings if your website is secure. So there's really no reason at all not to do this. And this is the simplest method I've found. Doesn't take long at all. Anybody can do it, and it's free. Let's get started. Okay, step one is to create an account at Cloudflare. Cloudflare is a CDN, one of the few CDNs to offer a free service. What is a CDN? It's a content delivery network. A content delivery network will speed up your website and make it more secure, so you should use one if you can. And since Cloudflare offers a free option, we should use it. Another beautiful thing about Cloudflare is that they offer free SSL. That's pretty amazing. So go ahead and sign up for an account. I already have an account, so I'm simply going to log in. Once you have a Cloudflare account, you're going to want to add a site to your account. So go ahead and click Add Site here, and then put in your domain name here. This is my domain name that I'm going to add SSL to. Then click Begin Scan. Now, while this is scanning, I'm going to show you something. This is a website I just threw together because I wanted to test out this theme here. It's called Sum, and it was made by this guy, Sammy. You really should check out his work. That would be a suggestion of mine over at foxland.fi. So what you don't want is you don't want an icon that looks like this. When you click that, it says your connection to this site is not secure. You don't want that. You want this. You want a padlock that says secure. When you click this, it says secure connection. Your information, for example, passwords or credit card numbers, is private when it is sent to this site. This is what you want to see, folks, and this is what we're going to do for this website here. So the next thing you're going to want to do is click Continue Setup here. You shouldn't have to do anything on this page. Just click Continue. Now we're going to select Free Website here. Then we're going to click Continue. Now, we have to change our name servers. This is really the only complicated part to this whole thing. We have to take these name servers here, exchange them for the name servers we are currently using. I'm going to show you how to do that. It's very simple. So my registrar is Namecheap. Namecheap is the company I used to get my domain name. This is where I manage my name servers. So here's the domain we're working with today, boringtips.com. I'm on my Namecheap dashboard. Now, different registrars are going to have different interfaces, so if you can't find the place to edit your name servers, contact your registrar's support department and ask them how to do it. But for Namecheap, it's easy. Simply go to your dashboard, find the domain you're interested in editing, click on Manage over here, and then scroll down just a bit till you see Name Servers here. So what we're going to do is we're going to go in here and we're going to get rid of these name servers. And we're going to put in the name servers that Cloudflare told us to put in there. This one here. We're going to copy it. We're going to paste it into name server 1, like so. We're going to take the second name server and copy it into name server 2. And then when we're done with that, we have to save it. In Namecheap, it's just this green check mark here. Now you're going to get this message that says DNS server update may take up to 48 hours to take effect. So yes, it can take time. I find that it usually takes an hour or less. Sometimes it's almost instantaneous. So once you've done this step, go ahead and click continue. We're back at Cloudflare now. Go ahead and click continue. Okay, and it says status pending. So if you click this button here and recheck your name servers, it will tell you when the process is complete. Okay, this took about 5 minutes and my site is now active on Cloudflare. You can only click the recheck name servers button once every hour, so I just refreshed my page after about 5 minutes and I can see now that my website is active on Cloudflare. Now I'm going to click on crypto up here above. These are the SSL settings. We want to choose flexible here. Now, flexible is the least secure option that Cloudflare offers, but it's also the easiest, and it's great for small businesses or personal blogs that don't accept credit card purchases on their website. So we can see that the certificate is active. That's great. Everything should be set up, right? Not so fast. We now have to install a plugin on our WordPress website. So go to your WordPress website, go to the dashboard, go to plugins, click add new, and then we're going to find the plugin we need. The plugin that we want is called Cloudflare Flexible SSL. Okay, here it is. Click install now, and then click activate plugin. Now, also keep in mind, when you see these kind of notifications here, like this little 5 in the blue circle, that's telling you you have updates. So you should always take care of those updates. We need to update WordPress here, and we also need to update a bunch of the plugins. This is not a site I work on very often, so that's why things are not updated. Anyway, now that this plugin is activated, and when we go back to Cloudflare, we can see that our certificate is active. SSL should work on our website, so let's check it out. What we need to do is go back to the main page, and then we need to type in HTTPS instead of HTTP, like so. And then click enter. Now we can see that the connection is not private yet. What this means is that Cloudflare is not done setting up the SSL certificate. It does take some time typically. So let's just check it again in a few minutes. Okay, I went and ate some lunch, and now I'm going to come back and check to see if my site is working the way it should. So I'm going to go to my site here, and I'm going to type in HTTPS colon and then 2 forward slashes like that to see if the SSL is working. Click enter and look, it says secure and I have the padlock. That is awesome. But am I done? No, because people can still get to my site by going to http://boringtips.com and it still shows that it's insecure. And if I have any search engine links active, and it's going to go to this one here because that's what the search engines have in their database. So we have to make sure that our site always goes to HTTPS. In order to do that, we need to go back to Cloudflare here and then go to page rules here. Click this here and we are at page rules. Now we're going to click create page rule. What this is going to do is force all our HTTP links to use HTTPS or secure links. Okay, so go ahead and put in your domain name here. Now we're going to insert an asterisk here and an asterisk here, just like this. The asterisks make sure that any iteration of your URL that somebody puts into their browser will be redirected. Okay, then click add a setting and then use this little drop down here to choose always use HTTPS. Click that, click save and deploy. Okay, now when we go to our site, let me just click refresh here and show you what happens. It's automatically redirected to the secure version of the site. So now, anytime somebody comes to my site, any page they go to, it's going to be secure. And folks, that's really all there is to it. But let's go ahead and back to our WordPress dashboard and do one more thing. Now this step is not completely necessary, but some plugins might rely on it. So let's do it. Go to settings and then to general. And then change your site address to HTTPS right here. Then scroll down and click Save Changes. Now folks, that's it. Anytime somebody visits your website, it will be a secure version of the website. That will make you happy, that will make your visitors happy, and that will make Google happy. Again, the only difficult part about this entire process is that you may have to wait a while for the changes to take effect. For example, you may have to wait for the name server's change to take effect. You also may have to wait a while for your SSL certificate to become active on Cloudflare. So some of these things are going to take time. Don't get frustrated if you don't get the padlock instantly. You will get it if you just wait a little bit. The very last thing I want to mention is that now and again, once you've done this process and then you start looking at the pages on your site, you may see that you don't have a secure padlock link on some of the pages. What that typically is a mixed content warning. What it typically means is that you have images on your site that you've inserted earlier that are using HTTP. So you need to go into that page or post, edit that page or post, and change the link to that image to HTTPS. Now, I've put a link to an excellent article in the description of this video on how to deal with mixed content warnings if you're getting them. So there you have it. In a very short time, with a few easy steps, you now have a secure WordPress website, and it is 100% free.